However, on this 45th anniversary of Bangabandhu, death anniversary of Bangabandhu, when 12 culprits, two killers, were convicted, they killed 17 people on the early morning of 25th August. Out of these 12 killers, six have been meted up with the justice. One died on abroad, and I'm told the five are still at large. We would request all our friendly countries of the world. We know the two of them. We know where are they living. And the rest three we don't know. We'd request all our friendly countries that they should help us in identifying those fugitives and send back to Bangladesh to face justice. We want to establish rule of law and justice and good governance. For almost 21 years, from 1975 to 1996, those killers were given indemnity from justice. But thanks God, the people of Bangladesh voted for the Awami League Party and elected Sheikh Hasina as a prime minister. And since then, in 1996, that indemnity law, that you cannot, file a case against the killers, that was abrogated. And our law minister has already stated that the following that we have instituted the cases in a very transparent and judicious way. We follow the rule procedures and rule of law. Anyway, so that's the story of Bangladesh. We are doing well. Currently, a country which is known as the bottomless basket is now known as a model of economic development. As per the Wall Street Journal, it is the standard bearer of the South. And many of my colleagues in the UN always used to call Bangladesh is a star of women empowerment. Under the leadership, able leadership of Sheikh Hasina, our current prime minister, we are doing well. And in spite of the COVID-19, we are more or less is managing it. While our total death rate due to the COVID is around 3,500 for a population of 165 million people. If I compare with some other countries whose has much less population, their number of death is much larger. So all said and done, in spite of our weaknesses, we are doing well. Thanks to God and thanks to our all friends who have been supportive of us in helping to overcome this pandemic. This pandemic cannot be resolved alone by one country. We have to have strong partnership and cooperation so that we can get out of this pandemic. And not only that, post-pandemic period could be more difficult. And therefore, I will urge all my friends, all the friendly countries to put our heads together, and we must work together for a better future for whole of the world after this post-pandemic period. And welcome all of you. Thanks for your time, your sharing with me. And I wish you good luck. I wish you, stay safe and healthy. God bless you. Joy Bangla, Joy Bangabandhu.
Thank you very much.